This dog was sad after she lost her babies, but someone unexpected came and rescued her. No one needs to be told how loving and adorable dogs are and can be. Even if you're a person who is afraid of dogs or doesn't like them, chances are you might change your mind if you spend some time in their company. These animals reciprocate with tremendous compassion to the slightest sign of love you show them. Dogs have strong parental instincts too. The she-dogs become very fierce and protective of their litter of puppies when they're born, and they are hurt just as much as humans when they lose their little ones. This is the story of one such dog. It is of two dogs, actually, who have different traumatic experiences. Show them the slightest form of affection and love, and dogs will become your best friends. They will sulk if they see you sad and wag their tails like crazy when you're excited. They respond in the most amazing and heartfelt ways to your emotions. They're even known to heal people and get them out of depression. But what happens when it's the dogs who are depressed? People adopt pets, but some cruel ones who find that they're not ready to take on the responsibility abandon their pets. These dogs are known as owner surrenders. If the dog is lucky enough, some animal shelter agency might find them and put them up for adoption. But if the dogs find themselves in public shelters, more often than not, they are euthanized. Public shelters cannot refuse to take in an animal as law. It is because of this that they are overcrowded, and because of that, that a lot of animals are euthanized there. Chances are that if you leave your pet in an animal shelter, it will be put down within days. How does your pet spend those days? Animals have a strong sixth sense, so they know when they're not wanted. They can feel what's going to happen to them. These dogs spend their days at the shelter in stress and confusion, and they literally seclude themselves in their sadness. If owners knew the conditions their dogs were kept in or what happened to them in a few days, public animal shelters would be a lot emptier. More than a million dogs in the US are euthanized every year. This was also going to be the fate of the dog we are going to talk about. You really do not need to get into deep scientific stuff. Suffice to know that oxytocin is a hormone that is known to cause love and jealousy when a she-dog is about to become a mama. Her body releases this hormone, making her extra protective and overly caring for her litter. The maternal instincts need a vent out, but what happens when a dog whose motherly instincts are strong doesn't get to be a mother? A mama dog who's delivered her babies in good health does not require any human intervention to take care of her litter. The motherly instinct makes her fierce enough to take care of herself and her little ones. However, dogs become depressed if their motherly instincts do not get a channel to be directed to. It happened with this particular dog. When a dog pregnant with 9 puppies was found in a bad condition, wandering on the streets, someone took her to the public shelter in South Carolina. The overcrowded shelter was on the verge of euthanizing this dog when Halfway There Rescue intervened and arranged a foster home. Halfway There Rescue was founded not so long ago by an animal lover, Sarah Lewis, and is currently run by 4 women. They rescue dogs from roads, streets, and even other shelters if they find out that the animal is going to be euthanized. They try to find loving foster and adoption homes for these dogs, and that's what they did for this 3-year-old, too. The 3-year-old dog was named Daya, and she managed to find a foster home. She was taken to the vet by her foster mother, but after her x-ray, a heartbreaking piece of news came forward. Daya was all excited and ready to have her babies, but the vet gave her rescuers really bad news. A video by the dodo attached ahead captures the entire ordeal. In an interview with the dodo, Jennifer Werner, a rescue volunteer, said, "X-rays showed no evidence of living babies. Her 9 puppies were in the process of being absorbed by her body. This had caused a severe infection in her uterus that required emergency surgery within an hour of her arrival at the vet hospital. Daya had to undergo a surgery in order to survive, but that meant she would not be able to see her puppies. The infection in her uterus was serious, and the surgery meant that she would not become a mother ever. Under the anesthesia, there was no way for Daya to know what was happening, and when she woke up, expecting to be overwhelmed by a number of puppies, she was perplexed. Daya survived the surgery, but the bad news was that she was never going to be a mother. Daya could not understand what was going on. She expected to see her litter of puppies, but she didn't even have one. She started sulking and was unable to handle the situation well at all, as is told in the video clip ahead. Daya was expecting to be a mom, hence her motherly instincts were on the rise. When she didn't have her puppies, she directed her love and care to inanimate things. She took care of toys and socks lying around in her new foster home as if they were her babies. She cleaned them and licked them. It was heart-wrenching to watch. When Daya's foster mom saw her taking care of toys and socks, treating these non-living things as her puppies, she was overwhelmed. She liked dogs and was compassionate, but nothing had prepared her for handling a depressed she-dog. She was at a loss. How to cheer Daya up? Nothing worked, and so she sent out a plea, as is told in this video clip. The second foster mom, Katie, told this about Daya to the Dodo. She was very much expecting to be met with a litter of puppies, and there were none. She was just really depressed. Her foster mom was watching that unfold and just said, "This dog needs help. She's not gonna get over this." While this was Daya's life, there was a dog somewhere else going through a worse phase. Jennifer Werner explained, she had a wonderful home to recover in, but her instinct had taken over with nowhere to direct her energy without her puppies. While everyone at the rescue was so happy that Daya had made it through surgery, we were heartbroken that she was missing her babies. She didn't understand what had happened to them. Somewhere, there was another dog in need of help. While Daya was in her foster home and the foster mom could not understand what to do, the rescue shelter got to know about a female pit bull puppy who had been hit by a car and abandoned. She was not well, had skin infections, and had one of her eyes ruptured. Rescue immediately rushed to her aid. One of the rescuers said, "I saw this gremlin of a dog. She just looks so pitiful. She has a ton of personality, but that has come with time, because obviously when she came to us, she was very sick. When the vet saw her, he kind of looked at her and thought, oh, I can save her, but I don't know who will want her after this." Raisin's eye was mutilated and the vet could not recover it. He had to take Raisin's eye out and stitch the skin. Raisin was lonely and extremely thin for a six-week-old puppy. Werner from the rescue center said, "Everyone knew that the puppy would survive with human intervention alone, but we had hopes that she could have the mama she was missing." Then, they had an idea. The adoption agency put out a post. "Mama is having a hard time understanding that she's not actually a mom. We know she's struggling. An opportunity arose today to potentially make her a mama again. Is anyone willing to take them both for a few weeks?" It was Daya's sheer luck that Raisin was a puppy needing motherly affection, but were they going to be receptive to each other? Daya's and Raisin's foster mom, Katie Levins, told the Dodo that as soon as she found out about these two dogs, "I came to Nick and woke him up in the middle of the night, said, 'We've got to do something.'" So they took both Daya and Raisin in. It was tough because Daya was emotionally broken and Raisin physically. Raisin was a recovering puppy. When she met Raisin, her foster mother said, "I mean, the photo was one thing, but then seeing her was another. I didn't even see Raisin because she was so tiny." But this was going to change. Raisin found a receptive and loving foster home. What did Daya feel? The foster mom said, "Daya was just immediately very receptive to the puppy. She just immediately started bathing her, licking her face, and licking her ears. And when Raisin reciprocated that and started licking Daya's face, we were done and we were like, we know this is gonna work. This'll be great." But this was not it. Daya was to leave. Soon. Daya was a loving mom according to her second foster mother. She was very maternal. She took Raisin right in. Raisin was helping Daya heal, and Daya gave her all to Raisin. "Daya was very protecting and I think kind of proud of Raisin," said the foster mom. But what was to happen when Daya left? Here is Daya towering over Raisin as if daring anyone to take her little adopted puppy away from her. And Raisin, sure of her mother's protection, is carefree. There were other animals with whom Daya and Raisin used to hang around, but Daya, the protective and sort of possessive mother, was always only a step away from Raisin and would not let anyone near her. Since Raisin and Daya found each other, they couldn't be separated even in their sleep. They planned their naps together and their eating schedules. Raisin felt loved and protected under Daya, and Daya gave Raisin all the attention this 6-week-old puppy needed. But time to leave was drawing close. Daya healed, the foster mom said. When she got to our house, she was just a mama dog. She had her own baby and she took care of that baby, and it didn't seem to me at all that she was struggling anymore. Now that Daya had partially recovered, it was time for her to go home. Raisin just kinda got protection and love for the first time, and that was important to come from Daya. I think in the end they both benefited from it. When they felt like Raisin was feeling a lot better and Daya seems to be doing emotionally better, she went home. Daya went back to her first foster mom, and Raisin needed a new elder to take care of her. It was hard to let go of Raisin, the foster mom said. I think I was lying to myself from day one. After Daya was out, I think we were pretty much dead set on having Raisin. Now she's bonding with our dog, and I think she learned all that from Daya. But Charlie was not excitedly receptive of her. Charlie was a little apprehensive around Raisin, his owner said. Charlie is a big dog and was terrified of her. He just didn't want to hurt her, so he was being overly cautious. Raisin, however, was too cute to resist. She is a strong and bouncy pup who even got Charlie to open up. When Charlie got to know that Raisin was a feisty pup, he got more comfortable. His owner said, I think he's assumed a lot of maternal qualities with her, even though that's a foreign concept to him, because he hasn't ever been around a litter of puppies before. Since Daya left, the Lovelock family tries to keep Raisin busy so as not to sulk for her mama. Charlie proved to be a successful distraction, and now that Raisin was growing up, they started sending her to play school with other pups. Here's the report card of this sweet little pup. And we don't know what the exam was, but Raisin surely passed with flying colors. Just like all other dogs, Raisin is growing up to be a notorious one, not knowing how to distinguish between her toys in the house and the pillows or papers. She messes the house up time and time again and gives Katie puppy eyes, and for the latter, it's hard not to forgive such an innocent face. The Lovelocks also have this 10-year-old black cat called Waze. She's moody like most cats, but she and Raisin get along just fine. As can be seen, when it comes to creating a ruckus, both team up and literally leave no stool unturned. This is just part of the mess they create every day. Now that Raisin is 6 months old, she's getting really active. All three of them sometimes sleep together, and Waze's and Raisin's furs make it difficult to recognize who's who. But then, Raisin's cool eye patch comes to the rescue. The foster mom said for Daya and Raisin, to see a bond like that form for two dogs we felt like really needed it is so rewarding, and it makes the fostering effort worth it in the end. Raisin is so little and sweet that she makes everyone want to protect her. There are always people who will abandon their dogs when it gets a little hard to get by, but it is nice to know that there will also be people who won't think twice before adopting broken or depressed pooches.